JavaScript has some very basic language basics worth knowing about. First, write your JavaScript from top to bottom, because that's how the browser will read it. A good rule of thumb here is to define all variables and functions and objects and anything else before you use them, so higher up in the file. That way you know the browser has read the object or the function or whatever it is before you call it. Otherwise, you might run into problems. Second, comments, like what you see at the top here, are used to leave literal comments for yourself and other humans to explain what's going on. When you create a comment, it is ignored entirely by the browser, so it's purely there for us humans. In my code editor right now, with the color settings, you can see comments are colored green. They'll always have a different color from other code, and it's always consistent in the way you see here. To leave a single line comment in JavaScript, you use two forward slashes and then just the string of text that is the comment. You can do that on its own line, and you can also do it inside another line of code. So here we have a declaration for a let, and then we have a comment directly afterwards. Just remember, everything behind the two forward slashes will always be the comment. If you need multi-line comments, you use CSS comment syntax. So forward slash asterisk to start the multi-line, and asterisk forward slash to end, and you can add as many lines of text as you want in between these two markers. If you're using a code editor like VS Code, there's also a shorthand for a more verbose type of comment. Down here, I have a function called update backpack, and if I enter forward slash and then two asterisks and then hit return, VS Code will create a verbose comment for me and even capture that this function has a parameter called update. It'll then ask me what type of data is in update, so I'll say string, and then I can fill in this comment. And here you see the purpose of a comment. Now when I come back to the code, I'll see, oh, there's a function here. It's called update backpack. It outputs HTML, and it has a single parameter. It's a string, and it's called update. Comments are also often used to quickly activate or deactivate single or multiple lines of code for debugging purposes. This is done by placing your cursor on the line or lines you want to comment out, and then hitting Control or Command forward slash. So if I hit Control forward slash, I comment out this line of code. If I do it again, so Control or Command forward slash, I uncomment this line. If I want multiple lines, I just highlight the lines, and again, Control or Command forward slash to comment them out. Control or Command forward slash to take the comment away. It's a very quick and easy way of doing debugging. Third, spacing or white space. In JavaScript, spacing is purely for the human user. That means the browser does not care about spacing at all. You can write all your JavaScript in a single line and the browser will still understand, but humans will not. So it's better to use spacing properly. The best practice is to use indentation to visualize hierarchy. You can see that down here. We have a constant called backpack, and then inside we've indented all the pieces that go inside, and there's some further indentation to show what the hierarchy is. Now, you may have heard a joke or two about tabs versus spaces. This indentation is what those jokes refer to. You see at the top here, this indentation currently is two spaces. Now, that joke used to make sense because you had to add either tabs or spaces manually to do indentation, but today this is all handled automatically by the editor. So if you see down here, it says tab size 4. So that means if I hit return here and then hit tab, here we have a single tab and it's 4 spaces wide. If I want to change that, I'll go into my code editor and say I want to indent using spaces, and then say how wide I want the indentation to be, 2. And then you see the indentation I created is automatically changed. So that way, no matter what the indentation is for a document, you can always just convert it using the code editor. And there's more. If you're using a tool like Prettier, this will be sorted out for you, so you don't even have to think about it. Fourth, semicolons. You will notice that I add semicolons to the end of all my declarations, and you'll also notice that Prettier will enforce this standard. Now, some developers will add semicolons to the end of declarations, others will not. Again, JavaScript does not care either way. This is a coding and syntax preference for us humans. In some coding standards, you are required to add these semicolons. In others, you are required to not add them. The good news is ESLint and Prettier will sort this out for you. So if you go look at code examples and you see either using or not using semicolons, know that this is just a preference. If anyone ever tells you it's wrong to do one or the other, that's simply not true. This is purely editor preference. So, and the tools we use will automatically sort it out for you. Finally, quotation marks. You'll notice in my code, I use double quotes for all strings. This, again, is developer preference. Some developers like to use double quotes, some like to use single quotes, and different coding standards will enforce different styles. So in some coding standards, single quotes will be enforced and applied using ESLint and Prettier. In others, you'll have double quotes and the same thing will happen. So just be consistent in what you're doing and the tools will figure out the rest for you. The rule of thumb to all of this is, number one, be consistent, and number two, use tools like ESLint and Prettier to automate this consistency.